10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Dire team ban. Radiant team ban.
Okay, now I'm here. Microphone unmuted, so we're all ready. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. My name is DragonDrop here, taking over for Basket in the grand finals of the Corsair Gaming Arena. Now, unfortunately, or fortunately for Signature Trust, no matter, depending on how you look at it, they won a LAN and remaining. They have to attend the winner's ceremony. So they forfeited their semifinals match up against Team Malaysia. Which is why we're right here in the grand finals already between Team Malaysia and 5EVER. So Basket won't be joining me here, he had some connection issues and he's gonna go sort them out now. So all the best to him, but of course giving me the chance here to bring you this game, I hope I can bring you as much entertainment as Basket has been able to so far, so big shout out to him as well. Bringing you coverage of this tournament.
Radiant team pick.
Alright, I didn't have too much time to set up all the overlays, so once we get into the game, I'll have to fix that up really quickly. So shouldn't be taking too long though, as it's kind of a quick and easy thing to do. But not the most professional. I like to prepare my overlays, but of course, I did not know that I would be streaming this on short notice like this. So please bear with me once we get into this. What we're getting into definitely now, though, is going to be the draft here. Team Malaysia banning out the Juggernaut as well as the Vengeful Spirit. Troll Warlord as well as the Sniper not going to be joining us, courtesy of 5EVER. So very standard bans so far here, all of those very popular heroes. Same with the Batrider, kind of an evergreen when it comes to hero picks here in a competitive manner, simply because he's such a solid pick, it's not even funny. Very strong initiator, of course, very strong simply because he can, no matter how hard his lane is, he can always come back simply because he is such an effective way to farm the jungle. So no matter how hard you shut him down in the offlane, he's always going to be able to come back into his own jungle and still get a blink dagger by 12 minutes at the max, as long as the supports are stacking for him. So that's kind of the main strength of the Batrider, or other heroes like Tidehunter that has been very popular in the offlane. Or Beastmaster even to some degree, not recently though, but for a while at least. All these heroes that have some sort of comeback potential, some sort of fallback in case the lane doesn't go too well. 5 seconds remaining. However, gonna go a little bit more aggressive here with their picks so far. Axe, of course, the embodiment of aggression here. Once I have his Blink Dagger, can also farm the jungle quite effectively, of course, to get there. And then once he has that, he wants to take over the game. He wants to be super aggressive, wants to get chops left, right, and center. And in a later game, he does fall off in terms of damage, as his skills simply don't scale too well here. Of course, the dunk will always be relevant, remaining. Especially if he decides to get an Agnum Scepter and pushes that threshold up a little bit more. But mostly what he's used for in the late game is very strong lockdown. That 3.2 seconds on the Berserker's Call that goes through BKB is just absolutely amazing on a low cooldown like that. Ancient Apparition as well, we saw that in the last game. Very strong hero. I love seeing it in play. It can be super annoying to play up against. It denies supports like Dazzle or Witch Doctor to a certain extent, because you're just not always going to be able to have that heal available to you. Same goes, of course, for other regen-based heroes like Necrophos. You don't really want to pick that up into an Ancient Apparition, as the Ice Blast is so freaking good. And it also works well in conjunction with another support if you want to go for an aggressive tri-lane, because the Chilling Touch can provide you with so much extra right-click damage early on. If you get that on a couple of heroes, then yep, that's a dead opponent right then and there. And yeah, not to mention the Ice Vortex, often forgotten here. But it is also a very strong spell, especially if you combine it up with something like a Scar of Mage, something along those lines that can really benefit from extra magic damage. Those, of course, also nice, and the Cold Feed may be the least exciting spell on the Ancient Apparition. But all in all, very strong support, very promising some more aggressive plays, definitely here. The Malaysia, though, can pick up the Viper, one of the better heroes to counter that. Counter magic damage as well, of course, with the Corrosive skin. Really hard to harass him out in the middle lane if they choose to run him there. Of course, Viper can also work in a safe lane as a solo, or of course also in a tri lane. It's also not something that you always see, but I believe that Viper in a tri lane is pretty damn good, simply because he can be a kind of a shield for supports in a way, because if you get close to him, you're gonna get harassed out with the poison. If you try to harass him out, you're gonna have to deal with Corrosive skin.
Radiant
and if you actually want to try and commit and killing him, then the supports behind him will be able to pounce. And by the same token, if you want to try to take out the supports first, Viper will just right-click you to death with the poison tag, which is just very strong early game. So we'll see what Malaysia wants to do with that pick going forward, as we have some more ban outs here. Malaysia banning out the Lycan as well as the Naga Siren.
10 seconds.
Very annoying heroes to deal with if you don't have the right lineup. Naga Siren, of course, you have to kind of shut her down or win the game before the Radiance really kicks in. Lycanthrope can threaten your towers and
reserve time.
Yeah, if you don't want to play against those, definitely not a bad idea to ban them out. Kind of restricts the kind of playstyles that 5 ever can go for. Wouldn't have expected them to go for any of these kind of playstyles here with an Axe and Ancient Apparition. I mean, if you have a Naga Siren, you want to go for a late game, and ideally with an Axe you want to take over the game and end it before it gets to that stage. But it, in any case, it would have been a good backup plan. So, who knows at this point. 5 ever banning out the Storm Spirit as well as the Lion. So, Lion also very strong support. Just because he provides so much disable and a lot of burst damage. Once he hits level 6, Storm Spirit, very tricky hero to deal with, as he can zip around quite quickly, of course. We all know what a Storm Spirit does, so I don't think that I have to explain that to you.
5 seconds remaining.
Witch Doctor on the side of 5 ever here, so not the most aggressive support lineup. I mean, if you want to pick up an Ancient Apparition in an aggressive tri lane, as I mentioned before, you kind of want to have a hero that provides lockdown. Witch Doctor with the cask, not really the case. Of course, they can still bank on the Axe to be able to lock down a target long enough. They really want to go for that, but I do expect a defensive stance here coming up from 5 ever. But what they're gonna have later is enormous extra physical damage. Just like in the last game as well, they picked up this combination. Ancient Apparition, Witch Doctor can be extremely devastating here. Especially once the Witch Doctor gets up the Dagon and Scepter, being able to bounce these things around everywhere. And so far Malaysia, they have a decent amount of cancel for that. They have the Flame Break, they have the Lasso if they want to commit that on the Witch Doctor. They have the Shadow Demon Disruption. Actually extremely useful here in this instance, just being able to save someone from a couple of damage ticks from the Ancient Apparition Ice Blast. That might be enough to keep you alive. Just being able to save someone from Axe Spins as well if they get cold. Zeus, a little bit harder to dodge here, I guess. 5 ever going all that combination with the... not really combination, Zeus is just straight up magic damage all day, every day. But of course, as I mentioned, the Ice Vortex will be able to augment that quite nicely. So that's probably going to be the mid here. And Mirana, okay, haven't seen a Mirana in a while. I love seeing that hero in action here. A lot of potential for good plays. Up against the Zeus, though, picking that into that is... can be quite tricky if 5 ever is diligent about just spamming their lightning bolt. If they don't see anyone on the map, then...
10 seconds remaining.
I mean, that free detection... not
five
want you,
seconds remaining.
Not necessarily what you want to pick a Mirana into. It just means that the Mirana
five
ultimate is gonna have
remaining.
Less of an impact, or less reliably of an impact. Then again, at this level of play, you're always gonna have to bank on the enemy team getting detection anyway. So, getting really good team fights out of that Moonlight Shadow really a big part. What is a big part of this pick, though, is the obvious combination with the Shadow Demon. It's one of the old standards, so to speak. Shadow Demon Mirana, Shadow Demon Mirana Bane. These combinations have been very popular for the longest time, and they never really got bad. It's just that teams shifted around to other strats and expanded their horizon, so to speak, in that regard.
10 seconds.
But yeah,
remaining.
Of course, having that disruption into the arrow combination can prove quite devastating for pretty much anyone here on the side of 5 ever. Maybe not Axe so much, because he can get quite tanky. Ember Spirit as well has the chance to get the hell out of dodge pretty damn quickly. But Zeus, Witch Doctor, Ancient Apparition, if they get hit by that, that's almost going to be enough to snipe them, even without any further extra damage here. Disruption into Soulcatcher into Long Range Arrow. Even without the stun, that's a hell of a lot of damage here that these heroes would have to deal with. So, yeah, Malaysia, they've got the work cut out for them in that regard. Ember Spirit, though, he's going to be the one position most likely with Axe in the offlane. It might even duo offlane here, the Ancient Apparition, if they want to try and secure the Axis farm a little bit more. Want to get some extra levels as early as possible on the AAA, which is not the worst idea ever. But yeah, that Zeus definitely going to be in the mid lane, up against the Viper, which is tricky. Tricky to say the least, unless they want to do something different. They can always run an offlane Zeus, I guess, with the Ember Spirit mid, Axe in the one position. I want to say that would be a little bit of a better matchup, but then Viper's just so strong in the mid lane, there's very few heroes that can actually stand up against them, and I guess Ember Spirit could be one of them, with the Flame God being able to at least block the magical damage from the poison attack and the corrosive skin. Then again, if you're out of Flame God, or if you're using Flame God, you're always going to be triggering the corrosive skin if the Viper is anywhere near. So, that in turn burns through the Flame Guard quite nicely, and we'll see how that works out. Last pick for Team Malaysia now is gonna be the Anti-Mage, okay. Yeah. Pretty good pick, I wanna say here. Ember Spirit, if you manage to lock him down for just a little bit, you'll be able to burn all of his mana. And Ember Spirit, very mana-starved. He was, of course, also very mana-dependent, so these kind of heroes can be essentially taken out of the fight if you just let an Anti-Mage chip away at them for a little bit. So a very nice pick, definitely some late game insurance, but they have a lot of potential here to also take over the mid game, to just not let this Axe get anywhere near the level of farm that he wants to. Alright, just gonna wait for everyone to pick their heroes, then I'm gonna switch to the other game overlay, and then I'm gonna have to fix that up a little bit before we actually start with the game commentary. Mentioned that before, I did take over this game quite a short notice, didn't have time to actually prepare the overlays beforehand, so please bear with me as I fix this up.
Prepare for battle.
That and that. This. I think it's this one. And put that just a little bit. We're not missing anything, guys. Can follow him. All right. One up. Put that in the right spot. Alright, we're golden. Sorry guys, but as I said, I didn't have time to prepare the overlays beforehand, so this should be good for now. Once again, if you just tuned in, this is the grand finals of the Corsair Gaming Arena here. With me, Dragon Drop, bringing you the game after Basket. Had some internet issues, couldn't continue streaming, unfortunately. And also, unfortunately for Signature Trust, they weren't able to play the semifinals match as they had to forfeit it. Okay, there's a disruption already. Arrow to follow. Chibix actually manages to dodge it. Shot a little bit wide, but it doesn't really matter here. Or does it? Yeah, with Batrider on front here. Body blocking. That's the first blood already. Once again, the strength of the Viper is shown here. Airway XY. Able to slow him down, doing a lot of damage with that poison attack. So, with that, let's actually head into the introduction. Skyway XY, as mentioned here on the Viper, gonna be heading to the mid lane. Ketik Imba here on the Anti-Mage. Not quite sure if that's his real name, but we're gonna go with it. He's gonna be taking solo safe lane for now. We'll see what these supports decide to do. Mushi on the Mirana, as well as Johnny here on the Shadow Demon. Probably going to be rotating around, making the most of their combination here as they rotate into the mid lane. On the Zeus, there we go. Disruption comes off, Arrow. This time around is gonna connect here, and that's gonna be another death. Teleport comes in, but it's a really long one actually. Yes, not able to save his buddy there. So we see how Team Malaysia wants to play this game already with ehome.my here on the Batrider, rounding out the lineup in the bottom lane. Also playing very aggressively here. On the Emmaspirit, played by Miracle, he's gonna get some help with Chibix here on the Ancient Apparition. I'm trying to do some damage, but he might get a turnaround on... Got a couple of charges actually already here on the Ancient Apparition, so he has to retreat. Cannot fight under the Firefly here. In mid lane, already giving up a kill, unfortunately, here is the Zeus, played by Polison KS, trying to help him, not quite there in time. He's the Witch Doctor, which leaves the offlane all to the Axe, played by Cal. Alright, that'll round out that, and yeah, don't have to tell you that Team Malaysia already got a good start here with their two supports. Claiming two early kills here, as they can really easily do, and now level 2 on Johnny as well. It's only gonna get worse having that Soulcatcher available. If you manage to isolate a target, you have that to amplify all the damage as well, coming out from the arrow and then eventually coming out from the Barstorm as well. They might get Cal here. They do throw the disruption, do throw the arrow here. It's gonna connect here inside KOX by joining the party, so that should be a dead axe by all means, or by all rights. Throws out the call just to get some extra armor, but I'm not quite sure that's gonna be enough. KS might just have to sacrifice himself here, and looks like that's gonna be the case. He's trying to heal up a little bit, but yep. Consolation prize, I guess, but a kill is a kill, as you do get the Witch Doctor. Same time, Batrider here in the bottom lane, already level 4. They haven't really been able to shut him down. KS had to try and help everywhere else on the map, so they couldn't really go too aggressive here on the Batrider with just an Ember Spirit and an Ancient Apparition. Just not gonna cut it. So that can be scary here. As yeah, Mushi and Johnny smoked up again. They're looking for more here. They definitely want to kill this Axe, who is also getting quite a few levels here up in the offlane at the very least. Not as much farm, of course, as he's up against an anti-mage. I mean, as an Axe, normally not really well good one-on-one hero, but you're always gonna have to be aware of these supports. They do miss the arrow here. Gets the call off, and Mushi actually do quite a bit of damage with the spin, so they might have to retreat here. Oh, catching him with so many spins here, almost killing him. He has to blink out, and once again, Cal survives at the mercy of RNG here, helping him out. Get some heals from his teammate here. But yeah, that arrow missing was kind of the setup for that. A little bit tricky to hit that if you have to try and dodge the creeps as well. So don't really want to blame Mushi there. But the thing is, they can just repeat that every single time. Once he has the 100 mana points again, he'll probably stack up the scam for the Batrider later, head back to base, and then Johnny in the meantime. There's a little bit of pulling here. And once both of them are topped up on health and mana again, they're gonna continue what they've been doing so far. All my spots are pulse on here at the bottom rune. Nothing will come of it. Yeah, and 5ever just trying the best to dodge these gangs, trying the best to stay alive, get as much farm as possible here in the lanes. But if you look at the bastard charge here, I'm not actually winning all that much. I mean, Miracle, actually very low down here in the bottom. Picked up a few too many creeps, it seems. He's probably gonna get a self here from KS. Or just a tango and some good restoration heals. Miracle has to be careful here. These supports start to rotate in. If Oh My just gets a couple of too many charges up, he does not have a... Yeah, he does have a stick. But that might already be too much. But that was the bait out here. Oh My gets caught the cold feet, maybe. No, barely gets out alive for now. One more right click, might be able to do it, but not with the butter charges. Now reinforcements come in. There's the disruption, there's the arrow, hits KS, so he's definitely going to fall here. Oh My still alive as Chibix is on the run. Miracle not really in position to fight as well, but now Cal might get a good call off here. Johnny should be the one that is to die here, and yeah, that's going to be the case. A lot of rotations here from both sides. A lot of bait outs here. Paulson actually dies in the middle lane. Did not quite catch that, but KOX, well, yeah, with the Viper Strike here and a couple of right clicks, being able to finish him off. Hard lane for Zeus here. Can't really rely on the magic damage to carry you through on just because of that corrosive skin. We see KOXY maxing that out as well for that very reason. Just so he can keep up with Zeus and keep the aggression up. If you look at Lars's Bad Rider for the longest time, was even ahead of the Ember Spirit. Of course, with him dropping so low, he had to fall back to base for the first time, I suppose. The Miracle had some time to catch up, but apart from that, Axe is getting some jungle creeps, which is nice, but not as valuable as lane creeps here. Viper will be able to catch up again here in that regard as well, taking back the middle lane. And of course, the Antimage is always going to be a liability here. Already has the Ring of Health on top of the Puma Shield and some boots, so going to be a relatively quick Battle Fury. Don't think he wants to go back for Midas at this point. With what items he already built. But yeah, quick Battle Fury, almost as good, if not better than a Midas here, as that enables you to farm just so damn quickly here on the Antimage. Bad Rider here on the other side. Ohio, who knows? already got level 6, almost level 7, 1200 gold, give or take, away from the Blink Dagger. So he hasn't been forced to rotate into the jungle, and that's a good smoke here. They see the illusion here, and KS thinks he's safe because of that illusion, but no, they were smoked up. There's the disruption, there's the arrow, nicely timed up. Even blocked in, maybe.
No.
I think. Not quite. But yeah, they do get the kill, of course. There's Miracle and Chibix looking for a way to counter grass here, but actually, Bushy has to leap away as he gets caught, but there's gonna be the follow. Miracle out of mana though, but the Zeus as well as the Flame God already going is enough to bring him down. Speaking of Zeus going down, he's gonna do just that as KYXY gets the revenge right off the bat in the middle lane.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Am I? He's just playing so damn aggressively here. Ohio. I'm gonna go back to base now. Probably transition into the jungle now, and yeah, Johnny has had some time to stack up this hard camp at the very least, so that's gonna be jump starting his Blink Dagger usage here as Cal. Oh, might get hit by the arrow, no, not quite. Saw it coming. It would have been a good one. They were jockeying for position here in this camp.
Tower,
but yeah, Antimage
needs
54 last hit. That's something that 5-ever is going to have to address sooner rather than later. In short, it's really hard to do. You kind of have to have some sort of lockdown. You have to have that call on top, and then you have to have enough burst to actually bring him down. Him also going for some early points into the spell shield. Going to make that much, much harder. He's still sitting in sidelines here. Looking for an opening. He's going to have one. Maybe. Johnny isn't here though, so it's not the easiest setup. Especially with a lot of raiding creeps around, so not gonna see any joy so far. Here, Johnny is actually down here in the bottom lane, trying to soak some experience. Has to be very diligent about it though, since there's a lot of activity here in the jungle as well. But yeah. So far so good, 2-7 on the kill board. Let's take a quick look at the graphs, and yeah, Team Malaysia, the commanding position here already going into the mid game. About 4,000 gold, 3,000 experience in the lead, and only going to get worse once the Battle Fury is up and running. Still gonna be a while, but still, it is going to come. Unless 5-ever decides to start rotating pretty damn soon. Then again, as I mentioned in the draft, Witch Doctor and Ancient Apparition, not exactly the best ganking team. You need more lockdown. And I mean, if you get the Seam Chains off, that can be enough. That's not really reliable in all circumstances. Same goes for the call, really, until Axe gets his Blink Dagger. He's pretty damn close to it. Not as close as the Bad Riders. Ohio has been able to pick that up already and might catch Miracle here. He's a little bit too aggressive. Ice Blast already online as well for the Ancient Apparition at least, so I've seen games when Ancient Apparition just doesn't hit level 6 until like 15-20 minutes in, and maybe not 20 minutes, but 50 minutes. And that's just super annoying to deal with. Next fight going very aggressively here. Don't know that he knows about the support on the side of 5-ever. X doesn't have the Blink Dagger yet. Can't really jump on him, so. But of course, KOXY doesn't necessarily know that. Might expect it though, and we have Mushi She smoked up here. Johnny on that's actually Ohio once again. On the other side, looking for a blink, looking to reveal it. He'll see everyone here. Will catch Shibix right into the arrow. But takes quite a bit of burst damage here from the Zeus, but it's not gonna be enough to actually save his teammate. And now he gets hit by the Viper Strike, but reinforcements come in means they're gonna have to retreat here. Searing Chains onto KYXY. What can they do to help him out? He's taking so much damage, but Miracle, a little bit out of juice here. As the disruption comes out, another arrow. No, actually spends some mana on the Star Stone, has another arrow and 5 mana, but a little bit too late to actually save the Viper.
Radiant's top tower.
And not the best decision here to go for the Star Storm instead of the arrow. It might have been enough to hold Miracle in place here. As it stands, it's a 1-for-1 trade here in this middle lane. Going in favor of 5 ever here. As they did get the Viper, who has been doing very well so far. He's still sitting on top of the net worth chart. And they only trade away an Ancient Apparition for it. Mushi is still sitting in sidelines, maybe looking for an arrow, but there's no one here to follow that up with. Meanwhile, in top lane, Hegemon gets hit by the Ice Blast. It's going to force him back at the very least. So, this tower not going to go down just yet. But yeah, that first Blink Dagger, not quite what they wanted. They got the kill. Of course, it's also as good as a setup of any for nice arrow. Even a better one, since you... If Mushi were to overshoot the arrow a little bit, you can still drag the target right straight into it, regardless, but... Not that he would ever need to. But yeah, just getting an Ancient Apparition and paying a Viper for it. Not the best trade, for sure. Well, Mushi might fall again, he will scout out Miracle. A little bit slow on the run, of course, if he gets here on chain, he can always leap away. A little bit safer than most, I suppose, but going to be able to retreat in time. KYXY here with the Vanguard completed, not going for the quick mech. Vanguard instead wants to be more tanky. Definitely agree with this choice. Oh, there we go. So because of that here, gets locked in place. Nice disruption here just to keep him safe from a lot of burst damage here comes out of it. And now, Batrider gets Cal here. They're locking him down. Polosun takes so much burst damage. Doing all of that as well. Miracle tries to clean up here, Moonshadow comes out before that. But they still get two heroes here, Miranda as well as Shadow Demon down for Axe and Zeus. Pretty good trade for Malaysia this time around, I want to say. Take a look at fight recap and yeah. It confirms that.
Radiant's top tower has fallen.
And top tower falls as well, it's... Even if 5 ever won that fight, you'd have to ask at what cost, and that cost is the Anti-Mage. Just getting online unimpeded. Gonna be a quick Battle Fury Hazard right now. 13 and a half minutes. Really good timing. Yeah, thanks, Edgeman. We know. So he's gonna be able to start farming like crazy. Get a... whatever he wants to, really. Manta style. Eventually, maybe Heart, Butterfly, something along those lines. The point is he can start fighting pretty damn soon once he gets his next major item. And that's when 5 ever is gonna have problems, right? His Ember Spirit, I mean, he's the highest farmer on side 5 ever, but he's nowhere near the Anti-Mage at this point. And he can't farm quite as quick. He's even going for a Yasha before a Battle Fury of his own. It's going to limit his fighting impact a little bit. It's a decent farming item, but... On most heroes, on the Ember Spirit, not so much, I wouldn't say. Ember Spirit, similar to Anti-Mage, kind of wants to have that Battle Fury to do damage in teamfights, but now he's gonna get caught, picked off here. Lasso into the arrow, easy pick off here, especially without the Flame Guard going. Yeah. Also something that you have to be aware of, Team Malaysia just has the superior pick-off potential. You can't feel as safe if you're playing for 5 ever right now. Of course, the flip side is that the Axe is around, but right now they have Vision on him. Even if they all the Anti-Mage, I'm not quite sure if they have enough burst damage. They kind of need that. Ah, oh, they missed the Ice Blast! They'll get the call off, but yeah, without the Ice Blast. Definitely not quite enough damage. And I guess with the Ice Blast, with the call, a couple of lucky spins, as well as the Zeus providing some extra damage, then they might be able to do it just because they're now only 2 points. Rotation marks, of course, only 2 points up into the spell shield. But even then, it's gonna be marginal at the best. As 5 ever shifts the focus once again here in this middle lane, They want Radiant's to take down the tower and want to take down map control. Attack. I'm gonna try and start limiting the area where anti-mage can farm comfortably. But they're taking a sweet time with it, of course they kind of have to. They have to be afraid of the Shadow Demon just being smoked up in the backlines, just being able to pick someone off. Have to be wary of the Bad Rider doing the same thing. Of course, Ohio's back at base right now, but however, don't necessarily know that. He's up the boots of trouble already. He's just so farmed as well.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Hell and KS, they're smoked up as well. Venice. They see Johnny, they definitely don't now here with the Moonlight Shadow coming out. And there we go. Central Ward goes down. Blink across, so no follow-up from that disruption. But yeah, no follow-up, no joy on that smoke as well. Malaysia knows what's up there. We'll be able to either consolidate their forces and try and defend this tier 1, or just do something else here. And they're gonna go for the split push. Tier 1 bottom is going to be the trade. Anti-mage still farming up on top here. Going to be able to put on some pressure on this tier 2 even in the top lane. Yeah, this mid tier 1 tower should fall. They might get the deny here. If there are, there's gonna be the cast, there's gonna be the ice blast as well. It's enough covering fire for them to... Oh, actually, Antimage, what's he doing here? He's going to be killed. It's caught by Miracle here, man fighting. But yeah, the double damage was probably the one that gave Miracle enough. Yeah. Enough advantage actually win that fight. If it doesn't have that, then it might turn out differently. All in all. But yeah, they do get the tier 1 tower, it's not going to be denied, so... And they do get the Antimage, which is a really big kill, actually. Bring him down as much as you can. He has Lovats already. Oh, they do find Johnny here. Takes so much damage from just a single Seung Chains after the Sleight of Fist. He has to retreat for now, and Miracle actually wants to go for the kill, and there's no support on the way for Johnny. He's super slow. Tries to fake out the dodge with the disruption. But Sleight of Fist does get the kill, so Miracle actually on good track, actually catching up with the Ember Spirit as well as the Viper right now. It's bound to be able to help him with that as well, so that's what they need. They need to have a strong Ember Spirit, they need to have him pull some weight. With the timing signal right now, he can do a lot before the anti-mage really can. I mean, Vladimir's is good and all, it's a good fighting item. But at this point, he's still rather squishy. He's hard to bring down, don't get me wrong. But if he stays in the fight for too long, if he gets locked down, as we saw before, and if they focus a little bit on him, if they get a call on him with a couple of lucky spins, then that's still enough damage to bring down an anti-mage who's sitting at around 1,000 health. Depending on what kind of boots he has equipped right now.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
EKB, next one on the list for Viper, so I'm not gonna go back for that mechanism. Mushi actually went for that Hannah Midas. It's a good item on Mirana as we see the Moonlit Shadow come out. Immediately scattered out as trying to go for covering fire. Meanwhile, the top lane Miracle actually gets caught with the lasso. Will he get out of time? Does he have a remnant up? Doesn't look like it. He throws out one now, and that's gonna be barely enough. Not quite enough follow-up damages. All the spells have been committed from these two heroes now. But yeah, Antimage actually being a little bit greedy, trying to farm the Radiant stack. Gets caught out, and yeah. With the Zeus on the field! That Moonlight Shadow is not a free get out of jail card, not by any means. But yeah, Hand of Midas on Mushi here. I like that choice. I mean, they got enough done in the early game to go for that item comfortably, and that'll definitely secure the late game. Because Mirana it's not the best carry, it's not the best clicker ever, but it's definitely good enough to be able to provide a lot of extra physical damage, a lot of extra utility still in the late game. So if you manage to transition out of a support position into that role, then kind of have an extra semi-carry. Always nice to have. Antimage is gonna see that Ice Blast coming in, so you think better of trying to farm those. You know, farming Roshan right for the taking, but don't think that 5 Viper can take that. don't have the best physical damage axe all alone, pretty much. They would definitely need Ember Spirit, but Ember Spirit also not the best Roshan taking hero. They don't have any minus armor to augment their ability as well, so Roshan not gonna be on the menu for them for quite a while. Neither for MY, they have a little bit of better tools here with the anti-mage as well as the long range arrow to help out a little bit. But for now, they're gonna go smoke. Get some vision up here as 5 ever. Gonna 5 and push down the middle. Smoke themselves! He's gonna pop each other's smoke. Now, who gets blink off first? No one really, and Batrider is the one being caught. Dunked upon the first dunk we saw in the game, Mushi, though. He's been able to get the hell out, but can they really fight us here? 5 ever in commanding position here. Without that initiation, Mushi is still gonna fall. Yeah, without that initiation from the Batrider, really hard to go into fights like this. Oh, a little bit of miscommunication here. They still get the... No, they don't get the Viper Strike applied thanks to that disruption, of course. Now Cal gets another call, catches the Viper, and now there's the Death Ward doing so much damage at the big heavy! And will at least keep him safe from all the magic damage that they still needed to actually bring him down. At the very least, what this does is going to is securing the tier 2. Glyph or not, new creep wave coming in. No one really in position to try and contest this. What's Anti-Mage doing? Yeah, he's trying to trade here, doing a little bit of damage to the tier 2 in the bottom lane. X Plus going to come out, teleport here from Kel. Try and catch him off guard, but not quite the case. So, 5 ever stabilized here. An Anti-Mage, I mean, still on top of the net worth shot, but Ember Spirit not far behind him, and that's a comfortable position for both teams to be in. It's a very even game, no matter what the graphs say. That's the collision of playstyles here. MY, if they get a pickoff, if they get a disruption into arrow, if they get a lasso into arrow, or just a lasso straight up, then if they start off the fight with a hero advantage, and of course it's gonna be in favor of them. It's a very diligent, constant scouting here with the Ice Boss and Roshan pit. Just making sure that there's no sneaky shenanigans going out here, coming out from the Anti-Mage. Yeah, it looks like MY wants to... They have to feel some sort of pressure here after losing another tier 2, or the first tier 2 of the game already. After a couple of pickouts here, so I want to get this Roshan, I want to secure that, and use Monet Shadow to scout out the outskirts a little bit. Maybe go for a kill if they manage to find someone. They do have this aggressive observer ward inside the jungle. Can help out tremendously, but yeah, they don't see anyone in the general area. Drop down another ward in this high ground. Now they're gonna go for a Roshan. Ice Blast comes in. 5 ever knows that this is happening, of course. No one farming the mid, there's no one farming top. So what else would they do? Yeah, Malaysia knows that they can't really go for that. Can't really commit on Roshan up against an axe. And they knew it, of course, as well. They only had Anti-Mage in there in the pit to minimize the impact of any sort of blink call. But that means that the Roshan just goes down so much slower. So much more opportunity for 5 ever to go and get into position. Speaking of position, going to take the tier 1 now. What they've been able to do, keep throwing our Ice Blast to scout into the latest as well here. Middle tower is being pushed. There's gonna be a lasso though onto Cal. Do they have enough damage? There's 3 heroes here, no support, but Cal already with BKB catching him here. Gets caught with the call under the death ward and the dunk to finish him off. A little spell to retreat here, KYXY. Nothing left to actually block him out. Won't cancel this teleport, so. And this call, I talked about in the draft, very strong knockdown, 3.2 seconds, going through BKB. But an Anti-Mage has that. Going for Mandostar by the looks of it.
But yeah. Tower is under attack.
Call under the Death Ward, no way for him to blink out. Another very important kill, and yeah, that'll propel Miracle as well. He's been farming much more than Anti-Mage. Anti-Mage has been trying to push more and has to be, of course, careful about that. Arrow just snipes off the creep. It's like, why me? Why? Didn't do anything wrong. But yeah. Gonna go try and fight KYXY in the front lines here. Gets caught with everything. Disruptor, keep him safe for now. Can the count initiate? That's the question here. Just gonna focus on trying to get KYXY out. Cass comes in, trying to lay this a little bit, but everyone's so low. Not really too much committed on the side of 5 ever. Radiant's top tower. Not too much extra here, but there we go. Blink into the lasso, miracle card. Didn't quite get out in time, and just always have to be careful about that. Polison out of mana here, and out of health points pretty damn soon. Finished off with the mana void. But I get some good counter kills here. Is 5 ever kind of overstayed the welcome a little bit too much. Well, that's gonna be the arrow. Try and help out Roshan, and yeah, of course, with two very important heroes down. Two heroes that they need to throw out the damage here in any type of fight. Malaysia smelts their opportunity here to go for Roshan, and that'll, at the very least, that'll secure the anti-mage's farm, if nothing else. And they should definitely secure the tier 1 at least. We'll see how aggressive they want to go with that Aegis of theirs. Akal is still here, of course. He has a Blink, he has a BKB, but he doesn't have too much damage on his own. Alright, let's take a new look at items here. Ancient Apparition actually going for the 4 stuff a little bit earlier. We saw that come up. Instead of going for Hand of Midas or Quick Aghanim Scepter, anything of the sort, which is something that you normally see from Ancient Apparitions. I mean, either go for the Aghanim Scepter straight, if you can afford it, or just scrounge up enough money to go for a Midas, so you eventually have that Axe. Going for a 4-star first to have some extra mobility, definitely useful here, up against someone like a Viper, up against someone like an Anti-Mage, just being able to carry him for just a little bit can be quite useful as well. Which actor, what he's going for? He's going for an Aghanim Scepter. Has the point boost already, still quite a ways off, of course. I mean, neither of these heroes really known for the ability to farm quickly. Radiant's middle tower. They push down this top tier 1 tower, gonna trade it for a tier 1 mid. It looks like here Malaysia wants to put on some more pressure. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Not on mid, but on the bottom here. It's a little bit easier to take it with the start that Anti-Mage had a little bit earlier. So gonna trade 2 for 1 tower so far. Yeah, Miracle all that's left here on top lane. You won't be able to take this tower himself, especially not with Mushi in position there. I'd get a good arrow with a good setup here. Johnny's here as well. Moonlight Shadow. Both to cover here their actions in the Radiant side jungle, and just both to make sure that they can catch anyone who dares to commit through tier 2 top. So very good exchange overall across the map here for Team Malaysia. Take a look at the graphs. Yeah, they're still ahead. Doesn't feel quite as hard though. 7,500 both in terms of gold and experience. But yeah, this passivity, it does benefit them tremendously here, simply because Anti-Mage can farm so much more quickly than the Ember Spirit can, if he just decides to. And speaking of farming here, they're not gonna do that, they're gonna fight instead. K-Y, X-Y, still gone on health, still good on magic immunity here. KS throws out a cast, not doing nearly as much here, and he will just actually blow up. Yeah, catching him up. Yeah, they do use the mana void, I was just gonna worry about that. just wonder about that, whether they had anything left. Dead buff that as well as the lesser to cancel that teleport. Make a 2 for 2 trade, a good one for Malaysia. They do get the axe and only pay the 2 supports. Though arguably, I mean, Mirana, you want to transition her into a core position. Or into a semi-carry at the very least, but is he able to go through the backdoor regen here? Not quite. Not quite, it goes back to 93, 91. But yeah, now with the creeps coming in, that's another tier 2 on the list. On the list of casualties here. Yeah. Extra map control means extra space for Anti-Mage to farm. The longer the game goes like this, the more he's gonna be ahead of the Ember Spirit, who does have his battlefield now. But of course, Ember Spirit, normally a hero that needs to fight to be able to keep up his gold. He can farm quite effectively, of course, but he doesn't have that blink potential. I mean, that's... Oh, they can actually walk right by each other. Yeah, Anti-Mage, one of the reasons he's able to farm so much is that low cooldown blink. That's just enabling him to go from camp to camp and farm those up extremely quickly. Not wasting too much time. Okay, lots of energy here coming out from Zeus. Someone's gonna scout both of those out. When Night Shadow comes out, Disruption just save himself a little bit of trouble, but he's still going to fall. Thanks to the call. Ice Blast here actually hits both of them. Under the cover of Moonlight Shadow. 360 no scope right there. Yeah, thanks for all these. Thanks for all these. We know, man. We know. Actually, we don't know. I saw the BKB on Intermage, didn't get the chance to talk about it. Didn't see the Crimson Guard on Viper, but of course, that's the natural conclusion. Going for Assange, probably going into Halbert next. Let's make sure that the Ember Spirit has a little bit of a harder time. Actually, Assange and Yasha. Okay, he had the Yasha before, never mind. But yeah, BKB, Crimson Guard, very defensive build here on the Viper. And I guess you don't need him for damage, right? So you can play him as a tank. And work quite nicely like that. Next item for him will probably be a heart, something along those lines, maybe a butterfly. They're too, they put more emphasis on right-click damage, but definitely him playing the tanky role is definitely a good choice, simply because they have the anti-mage to do enough damage. You have the Morana able to provide that little bit extra when she gets her items up. Looks like she'll be going for BKB as well here, with the Ogre Club already up and running on Mushi. And BKB Gaming here, definitely, yeah, what you want to go for here, considering that you have an Ember Spirit who can provide actually a decent amount of magical damage. Of course, the later the game goes, the less it's going to be an issue anyway. But it's mostly the Zeus. Right? Mostly the Zeus, mostly the lockdown that 5 ever has, apart from the call. Okay, I caught that one. I saw you. But yeah, it's mostly the Zeus, because his magic damage actually scales pretty damn well, simply because all of his spells, apart from the ultimate of course, but his Arc Lightning and his Lightning Bolt are pretty damn spammable, together with the Static Field being percentage-based. Yeah, make no mistake, can't just ignore Zeus in the late game, can't just leave him alive. Lucky thing is that he is rather easy to bring down most of the time, so... Okay, top lane, Mushi gets caught here. A little bit of help. She misses the dunk. But still get the kill, and yeah, Johnny is well in the back of that. What was that? Ancient Apparition, okay. Really hard to catch all of these kills as well, because you have to kind of have to keep track of every single Ice Blast, and then every single Zeus ultimate to try and help and finish those off. Speaking of finishing someone off here, I need some... yeah! That mana burn. Dies out. Yeah, with the Manta Saw, it's an easy pickings, easy pickoff on the Ember Spirit. Gonna dodge the cask here with the BKB, and now they catch him, stop the TP with the Mana Void. Definitely useful. Well, definitely the right choice. That's a double kill to the Anti-Mage, and that's something that you don't want to do here. It's gonna propel him even further ahead than he already was. Now, you saw before, Ember Spirit was 1,000 gold ahead of the Anti-Mage at one point. Now it's back to about a 4,000 lead in the other direction, so... see what he wants to do with all of that gold. Sitting at 3,700, so he's sitting on the lead that he has right now, so it's... it's not an effective lead, considering. Ember Spirit gonna go for the crit, yeah, they definitely need him to do that physical damage. He can't really rely on being able to get a good death ward off. Between the damage potential and the lockdown that MY has available to them. Oh yeah. Relatively passive game overall, didn't see too many kills. Casted some South American Dota and some other Southeast Asian Dota recently that had a little bit more action, but of course this is the Grand Finals. Don't really want to commit too much. Want to make sure that you win the game as safely as possible. You don't want to give up any sort of silly kills by overextending, by being a little bit too aggressive, fishing for an extra kill. And like this, Kaber, X-Y, and Omai, they could definitely go and try for this kill, but they would definitely need some more help, and they will get it in the form of the Anti-Mage, and with that, we saw before what happens. Oh ho ho! Nice Ramon back though. And the issue that you have playing up against an Ember Spirit, if he's vigilant enough to always have a Remnant in the back, then you're gonna have a hard time catching him unless you blink right on top of him and have the lasso already queued up. Or you have some sort of silence. to prevent him from being able to get to that remnants right away. Herkul's gonna bait out a little bit now. Kal and Shibik's in the back lines here, waiting for an opportunity to strike. Well, Anti-Mage actually going pretty damn strong, he has to be careful about this. But then again, Team Malaysia has their team behind that as well. Arrow actually finds KS here. And yeah, they're gonna pick that off immediately, but there's the call. KS still alive for the time being. They get the lasso on Kal, and now the Ice Blast coming in, catching him up. Yeah, it's gonna blink right up. They're gonna try to bring him down, and the Mana Void. Once again, they cancel the teleport, so Kal is going to fall. Does some good damage in return to Anti-Mage though, but doesn't matter here. Miracle finishes off. Finishes off Shadow Demon in return. KOX, by though, trying to do what he can do, but without any lockdown on his own. Can't really stop the teleport from happening, and everyone else running away from him. Anti-Mage did go for Heart of his own. So he's super hard to bring down, super tank here. 2,800 health points here, and of course a lot of health regen to carry him through. He does see that Zeus is here, so but Miracle as well. Game is paused. Thank you. It's not an ideal time to pause, to say the least. I mean, don't think Miracle should die. He still has another remnant. They can conceivably fight here. Especially with the BKB down on the Anti-Mage, but Ohio's coming in. He has a Blink, he has a freaking Hex, by the way. Blink, Hex, as well as a 4-star of KYXY. With the Blink of Zone as well. Going for mobility rather than more tankiness just yet. We're gonna have a quick pause though for multiple reasons. Give me a chance to actually drink a little bit. Right, I'll also see if I can find co-cast for the rest of these matches. Because, yeah, if they're long like this all the time, then as a solo caster, it is quite exhausting. Alright, game resumes here, and Anti-Mage still going strong. They don't want to fight. They kind of had a feeling that reinforcements were coming in, so just get the hell out. Miracle farming something on the way. Still has a remnant, so a little bit interesting here to see them delayed for a fight. He's quite fast as well, has a haste rune, so really fast Piglet. They won't get anything of this sort, but that still opens up the Roshan just a little bit. Ancient Apparition does not quite have the Dagnum Scepter of his, so level 2 Ice Blast, scary enough, but not against these kind of high health heroes. Need to be able to shrug that off. This Roshan actually falling pretty damn quickly here. KYXY has some right click damage, of course, not the major part of that. Yeah, that's another Roche, that's an Aegis going the way of the Viper actually, and yeah, they kind of feel comfortable of having the Anti-Mage not have it. He's kind of tanky enough to survive through anything that Viper has to offer here. That gives it to Viper, who is going to be the frontliner anyway. So, he should be able to force down his last remaining tier 2 tower with that. So, Viper, I'm playing split pushing game a little bit. Okay, well, XY though, blinks right in. Forces him out, scares him a little bit. That was quick remnant back once again. Of course, you can't just commit to fighting there. If there's anything else behind that Viper, gonna have a bad time. Yeah, if you take a look at the vision here, there's absolutely nothing for the side of Viper here. No wards up anywhere. Neither for the Malaysia, but of course they have two creep waves on the other side of the map. Gives them some intel. XY here, Polisson, pops the Inverse Rune. Is there detection? Don't think so. Just yet, they do have a gem on Batrider, and that's gonna join, so Polisson. He's going to fall before he even gets his ultimate off. He Easy pickings there, all alone on the wrong side of the map. Take another look at any other items. So, Agnum Scepter, 4 star from Zeus, who just died, of course. KS still working on that Agnum Scepter of his own. Don't think he's getting anywhere near it unless it's already on the courier. And of course, he's the one buying all the wards, so wouldn't expect him to get a quick axe. Ancient Apparition is gonna have that soon. Cal, what is he going for? Yeah, he has a blink. Looking for an Assault Cuirass, but he hasn't had the best luck in terms of gold gain recently as well. On the side of MI, looking a little bit better here. The mine is paying off for Mushi. Got the BKB finished. And does he have anything coming out? Has a Basher coming out. That's going to be for the Anti-Mage, I guess. Yep. As Kero X was actually unstoppable. When was that happening? Not here in the middle lane, okay. Sorry, guys. A little bit too caught up in the items there, so yeah. I was expecting them to force down a tier 2, and that's exactly what they're going to do now. With the Ancient Apparition down and no buyback, they can actually go for high ground without having to worry about the Ice Blast. Basher up and running, of course, as well on the Anti-Mage. His net was just off the charts. So the question is, can they go for... can they get... can they get a fix on the Ember's Bird? If they get a lasso on him and bring him down, then it's pretty much going to be the safe way into the base. Because he's kind of the one that provides all the damage at this point. Axe, as mentioned in the draft, is falling off. He's not even there right now. Of course, he can always teleport back. But yeah. Either they should definitely get Miracle. If they can get him, then it's going to be an easy ticket. The Axe can be a problem, though, as a counter-initiator. So they're also going to have a fix on him. If they can pick him off before him as well, that's the ideal situation for Malaysia. Now, putting on some pressure on top, Miracle zips back to his Remnant again. So no committal from either side just now. Throwing out a couple of those. Now Cal with the call onto the Mirana. There's the fight coming out here. Gachigima found himself a target here. Demonic Purge is going to slow him down long enough. Kel, first one to fall. He Moonlight Shadow to give them covering fire. Nice arrow here on Miracle in the back. Yeah, 4 stars not going to be enough here. Even committing to the lasso. That fall comes out, doing quite a bit of damage here. But now, with a Flame Rack enough to bring him down, to get him out of that. Double buyback comes out. Triple kill for the Anti-Mage already, though. He's still going strong. Is the rest of the team, though, taking quite a bit of damage here? Aegis is going to be triggered on the Viper, is just going to blink out. Dodge is going to retreat here after losing. Oh, maybe not here. Miracle, no Remnant here, so he's just going to be burned out of mana. That Basher working overtime for them, just a little bit of lockdown needed to bring down the Ember Spirit, and now just going to go from bad to worse here. No buyback in him. Down for 100 seconds. Just, yeah, Anti-Mage, he has a freaking Heart of Thrask. He's going to be able to, he's going to be... Sorry, guys. He's going to be up to 3,000 health points sooner rather than later, and KMX, of course, with the Aegis trigger, is backed up in fighting shape as well. And you forward aggressively here just to keep them away, just to make sure that this tower is not being contested here. They still have the axe, but they have no damage here. They have absolutely no damage up against these two heroes. With their inbuilt magic resistance, Zeus is not going to be nearly as effective. It's going to be the call, it's going to be Ice Blast, it's going to miss here. Quite some good damage actually still coming out. But there's the BKB now. Cal, next one to die back. Godlike Streak here on the Anti-Mage, and he's not done yet. There's an Abyssal Blade here, even on the Ancient Apparition, to bring him down. And GG, well played, it's called. Yeah, this escalated quickly. Where's my right? There we go. As team.